This is the first time, honey, we're getting together. Oh, baby, I feel so good.
Okay, now I'm going to present definition of acceptance of bid of exchange. The definition is process by which a buyer or a drawer accepts the seller's bid of exchange by signing under the words accepted on face of the bill. Okay, by this act, the drawer becomes the acceptor and converts the bill into a post date check, an unconditional obligation to pay it on or before its maturity date. And based on section 17, subsection 1, act of bill of exchange, the acceptance of a bill is the signification by the drawer of his asset to the order of the drawer. Let's see.
First, be in writing. The drawer of a bill should give his assent by putting his signature on the bill. Second is duly signed by the acceptor, which means signature of the acceptor is necessary not only to constitute a valid acceptance but also to make the acceptor or drawer liable on the bill. Third is apparent on the instrument. Acceptance must be made on the face or back of the instrument, either by writing the words accepted followed by acceptor's signature or by merely signing. Fourth is after signing, be the instrument delivered back to the holder. It means the acceptor, after giving their assent to pay the amount as mentioned in the bill, must return the instrument back to the drawer. Fifth is absolute and unconditional. The acceptor must agree to pay the amount as mentioned in the instrument in full without any condition or limitation. Lastly is made by drawee only. A bill of exchange is accepted by the drawee only. You also can refer to the section 17, acts of bill of exchange. Examine bills of exchange. That's all from me.
Now I'm going to explain you about the endorsement and delivery. What is endorsement? The person who signs the instrument is called the endorser. The person to whom the instrument is called the endorsee. Writing anything on the face or on the back of the instrument for the purpose of negotiation. Such a writing must be signed by the endorser. Next, the last one is the simple signature without any words will also constitute the endorsement. Next is the effects of the endorsement. An unconditional endorsement followed by an unconditional delivery of the instrument as following effects. There are three effects. First is the property in the instrument stands transferred to the endorsee. The endorsee gets the rights of the further negotiation of the instrument. And the third one is the endorsee is entitled to sue all the parties whose names appear to it. Next is the condition for endorsement. First is the endorsement must be written on the bill itself and signed by the endorser. It is directly written on the back. Example, if a bill is for Rs. 100 again, it is not permissible to endorse it for 40 ringgit for A and 60 ringgit for B. Next, it must be an endorsement of the entire bill. Third one is where a bill is payable to several payers. All the payees must endorse it unless the one endorsing has authority to endorse for all the others. When the payee for the endorsed name is wrongly spelled, the payee or endorser should endorse according to the spelling on the bill. Next is the types of endorsement. First is blank or it's called or general endorsement. When the endorser signs his name only the instrument for the purpose of its negotiation, thus in such an endorsement, endorser does not specify the name of the endorsee. The instrument becomes payable to the bearer even though originally it was payable to order. the section 34, subsection 1 explains that an endorsement in blank specifies no endorsee and a bill so endorsed becomes payable to bearer. Next, the type of the endorsement is full or special endorsement. The endorsement in full is one in which endorser not only signs on the instrument but also specifies the person to whom or to whose order the instrument is payable. Such an instrument remains or becomes an order instrument. First of full endorsement is conversion. The holder of a negotiable instrument endorsed in blank may convert the endorsement in full. Next is blank endorsement followed by a full endorsement. The endorser in full shall be liable to his immediate endorsee and to any party directly title from such endorsee and not to others. Section 34, subsection 2 explains that a special endorsement specifies the person to whom or to whose order the bill is to be payable. The third one is the restrictive endorsement. It's the one which restricts or prohibits the right of further negotiation of the instrument. The fourth one is the partial instrument. Sometimes an endorsement purpose to transfer only part of the amount of the instrument. But sometimes the amount due on the instrument is paid in part and a note to this effect is endorsed on the instrument. On such case, the instrument may be negotiated for the balance. Next is the last one is the conditional or qualified endorsement. Endorser inserts a condition in his endorsement. First is stands with cost endorsement. In such a case, the endorser inserts certain words in his endorsement to exclude or limit the liability. Next is the liability depend upon happening of a specified event. The third one is the facultative endorsement. Facultative endorsement means an endorser by express words in the endorsement makes his rights or increases his liability on the instrument. The last one is self-express endorsement. An endorser does not want to incur any liability for the expenses that may be incurred on account of the instrument. In such case, the endorser usually adds words self-express or without expenses to the endorsement. Next is the delivery of the bill of exchange. A person is not liable on a bill unless it is